We invite you to please stand.
Blessed be the one holy and living God.
Glory to God forever and ever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
O God, the maker and redeemer of all believers, grant to the faithful departed the unsearchable benefits of the passion of your Son, that on the day of his appearing they may be manifested as your children, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
O Alpha and Omega, Creator of all, we pray to you for those we love, but see no longer. Grant them your peace. Let light perpetual shine upon them. And in your loving wisdom and almighty power, work in them the good purposes of your perfect will, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seem to have died, and their departure was thought to be a disease, and their going from us to be their destruction. But they are at peace. For though in the sight of others they were punished, their hope is full of immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace, he will shine forth and will run like sparks through the stubble. They will govern nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord will reign over them forever. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his holy ones, and he watches over his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. What I am saying, brothers and sisters, is this. Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. Listen, I will tell you a mystery. We will not all die, but we will be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For this perishable body must put on imperishability, and this mortal body must put on immortality. When this perishable body puts on imperishability, the mortal body puts on immortality. Then the saying that is written will be fulfilled. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, anyone who hears my voice and believes him who sent me has eternal life and does not come under judgment, but has passed from death to life. Very truly I tell you, the hour is coming and is now here, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For just as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son also to have life in himself. And he has given him authority to execute judgment, because he is the Son of Man." Friends, this is the good news, the gospel of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord.
In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Want to welcome all of you who are visiting with us here at St. Paul's, no matter what tradition or lack thereof you come from. We are blessed and honored to have you with us as we gather this afternoon for this very special service. The service of all souls. And this afternoon, we're invited to contemplate the great mystery that is death. And from the perspective of theology, when we talk about mystery, we're not talking about a riddle that one seeks to solve, but rather a reality whose depths can never fully be fathomed. And so we're invited into the great mystery of death. For us as Christians, death is a part of a wider journey that is eternal. So we hear from that beautiful book of wisdom, the souls of the righteous are in the hands of God. That whole image is a holy, powerful mystery to exist in the very hands of our Creator. And we come together this afternoon believing in that Creator, believing that God is a God of life, and that life is, in fact, stronger than death. And so this gathering this afternoon is bittersweet, bitter for all of the obvious and appropriate reasons. Because we believe in eternal life, that doesn't make the mystery of death any less painful. We mourn, and it's appropriate, and it's healthy to do so. We mourn those who we love but see no longer. And so we gather this afternoon in that pain, and that mourning, and that grief, hoping to find some measure of consolation, not to find a fix, for there is no fix to our grief, but to find some measure of consolation. And so we gather, thinking of those who have gone before us, whose memory, pray God, be for a blessing. Imperfect, perhaps a loved one who has wounded us or we wounded in one way or another. And before that wound was able to be reconciled and healed, that loved one has passed over the river of death. And we come in the great mystery that is life and death, perhaps praying to God, asking God for a grace to help in the ongoing process of healing. And for others, memories that bring great joy, memories that still tickle our heart. Perhaps for those memories, we thank God. We thank God for the gift that those memories endure, that death cannot vanquish that special place that our beloved deceased have in our hearts. And for that, we're grateful. Bittersweet. And there is sweetness in this gathering. There is the sweetness of remembering loved ones, remembering days past that still bring joy to our hearts. Sweet in that we can remember, and that we can still feel connected. Sweet in the hope that one day we will meet again. That eternal hope that is the gift of faith. Here at St. Paul's, for those of you not familiar with our campus, to our north, to our immediate north, my left, your right, as you sit facing the altar, is a very sacred space. It's what we call the columbarium. And there, many of our beloved, their earthly remains have been laid to rest there. And very intentionally, our columbarium reflects our Christian faith, because really throughout the year, and we're blessed here in South Florida, that plants and particularly flowers bloom throughout the year. And so this is virtually always a flowering garden of life, reflecting our faith, which is a gift from God. Our faith that while our beloved deceased have entered fully into the mystery of death, yea, though they be raised again, and their company we will, pray God, enjoy again. And so as we gather as people of faith and perhaps as people who are not of a particular faith perspective, we gather as members of the human family. We gather to bring consolation to each other by our mutual prayers. We come in the presence of a God who has created us, who sustains us in life, and who welcomes us in a mysterious and profound way through that eternal passage we call death. For life has changed. It is not ended. That is our Christian faith. And for that, we are grateful. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May their souls and the souls of all the departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Let us please stand. And let us now reaffirm our faith in our God of resurrection with the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day,
and now the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please greet one another in the name of Jesus.
Once again, good afternoon, everyone. I want to, this afternoon, first and foremost, present somebody well known to all of you who are members of St. Paul's congregation, and for those of you who are regulars with our Music at St. Paul's concert series, and that is our own wonderful Dr. David McFarland, Director of Music Ministries here at St. Paul's. I have to say, David, today you have outdone yourself. Isn't this incredible? The choir, our instrumentalists, just absolutely beautiful music. So uplifting, and so comforting. Thank you for that. This beautiful Requiem Mass setting of Rudders is truly remarkable. And so it is truly for us an opportunity to thank God for the gift of this beautiful composition and a choir and musicians to lead us in song so well. What a blessing it is. I just want to draw your attention to the back cover of today's program. On the cover is our Music at St. Paul's concert series. I encourage you to enjoy this incredible chamber music. You know, we are in our 34th season of music at St. Paul's. And today and throughout this season, we are honoring the late Dr. Stuart Gardner. Dr. Gardner was the longtime director of music ministry here at St. Paul's, and he was a driving force behind getting music at St. Paul's off the ground, this wonderful concert series that the community loves so very, very much. And it is a blessing for us to be able to keep the joy and wonder and beauty of chamber music alive and well here in our beloved Delray Beach community. So part of all of those that we will gather and remember at Eucharist this afternoon, we'll pray in a special way for Dr. Stuart Gardner, for his family, and all of those who mourn in a particular way his passing. He died this past summer, and we remember him fondly. The inside back cover does have a little bit of information about Dr. Gardner. I do have to say, this is a young picture of him. That's a Dr. Stuart Gardner I didn't know. I knew him in a little bit of an older version, but that being the case, a remarkable life lived, a life dedicated to sacred music and to the worship of God through the beauty of music. And we remember him fondly today. Our offering this afternoon all goes to support this wonderful Music at St. Paul's concert series. So we are grateful for your generous support this afternoon. Let us walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thanks, Pastor. Thanks, Val.
This Requiem Mass is offered to the glory of God in a special thanksgiving for the gift of God's love for God's people and the repose of the soul with God in heaven of all God's beloved children. And especially this Mass is offered to the glory of God and in thanksgiving for the life and ministry of Dr. Stuart Gardner. I invite the congregation to stand, please. Continuing with the great thanksgiving, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and a joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who rose victorious from the dead and comforts us with the blessed hope of everlasting life. For to your faithful people, O Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when our mortal body lies in death, there is prepared for us a dwelling place eternal in the heavens. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Continue to stand or kneel or be seated as is your custom or as you are comfortable. We acclaim you, Holy Lord, glorious in power. Your mighty works reveal your wisdom and love. You formed us in your own image, giving the whole world into our care, so that in obedience to you, our Creator, we might rule and serve all your creatures. When our disobedience took us far from you, you did not abandon us to the power of death. In your mercy, you came to our help so that in seeking you, we might find you. Again and again, you called us into covenant with you, and through the prophets, you taught us to hope for salvation. Father, you love the world so much that in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son to be our Savior. Incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, he lived as one of us, yet without sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation. To prisoners, freedom. To the sorrowful, joy. To fulfill your purpose, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the grave, destroyed death, and made the whole creation new. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died for and rose for us, he sent the Holy Spirit, his own first gift for those who believe, to complete his work in the world and to bring to fulfillment the sanctification of all. When the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, his heavenly Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. At supper with them, he took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Father, we now celebrate this memorial of our redemption, recalling Christ's death and his descent among the dead, proclaiming his resurrection and ascension to your right hand, awaiting his coming in glory, and offering to you from the gifts you have given us this bread and this cup. We praise you and we bless you.
We praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, Lord our God.
Lord, we pray that in your goodness and mercy, your Holy Spirit descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be the holy gifts of your people, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that all who share this bread and cup may become one body and one spirit, a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your name. Remember, Lord, your one holy Catholic and apostolic church, redeemed by the blood of your Christ. Reveal its unity, guard its faith, and preserve it in peace. Remember Michael, our presiding bishop, Peter, our bishop, and all who minister in your church. Remember all your people and those who seek your truth. Remember our beloved brothers and sisters of St. Paul's Parish, whom you called home over the last year, especially Stuart Gardner. Remember our brothers and sisters lost to the ravages of the COVID-19 virus. Remember all who have died in the peace of Christ and those whose faith is known to you alone. Bring them into the place of eternal joy and light.
Thank you.
and grant that we may find our inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, with patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, with St. Paul, St. Matthew, Blessed James Holly, and all the saints who have found favor with you in past. We praise you in unison with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Jesus was known to his disciples in the breaking of the bread. Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you. Feed on him in your hearts. By faith, with thanksgiving. All persons are welcome to receive the blessed sacraments of our Lord's body and blood at this altar. If you would like to receive our Lord's sacraments with non-alcohol wine or gluten-free bread, you may do so by using the station to the far left of the altar rail. Let us now give thanks to God for the gift of this holy meal that God has fed us with here this afternoon. And together, let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you that in your great love,
you have fed us with the spiritual food and drink of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ,
and have given us a foretaste of your heavenly banquet.
Grant that this sacrament may be to us a comfort in affliction and a pledge of our inheritance in that kingdom where there is no death, neither sorrow nor crying, but the fullness of joy with all your saints, through Jesus Christ our Savior.
Amen. Eternal God, you hold all souls in life. Give to your whole church in paradise and on earth your light and your peace. And grant that we, following the good examples of those who have served you here and are now at rest, may at the last enter with them into your unending joy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
May the God of mercy, may the Father of mercies and God of all consolation pursue you with untiring love, comfort you in your loss and sorrow, gently wipe away every tear from your eyes, and lift you from the depths of grief. May the love and peace of the Lord Jesus Christ sustain you in hope until at last you are reunited with those you love. May Almighty God bless and console you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.